2022 online applications to study at the Northwest University have been open for a while, probably since the 15th of April until now, and they will be closing mainly end of August and all of the programs around end of September. So today in this video, you learn how to apply at the University of the Northwest, which consists of three campuses, if I'm not mistaken, the Mafikeng, the Vaal, and the Potchefstroom campus. Manqoba here is all about helping each and everyone to revive their ambitions and reinforce their dreams. So invite a friend if you know someone who wants to study at this university or has been struggling to apply at this university. Please invite them. Let's do this application together. So this university consists of six faculties, which is the Economic and Management Sciences, Education, Engineering, Health Sciences, Humanities, Law, Natural and Agriculture Sciences, also Theology if you'd like to study Theology at this university. So this university does offer undergraduate studies, honors or postgraduate studies, or diplomas, also certificate, postgraduate, masters and doctorate student, open e-distant learning. You can also change your application details here. How do you do that? You need to send your request to this email address that you want to change your application or whatsoever your or contact information. Okay. Then please note that all applications will be closing on 30 September. Some will be closing 31 August. Some they are closed, especially those under sciences and some other that are selection courses. So you can click here to verify which are those courses and check if what you want to apply for is not yet open. Sorry if I have delayed. Applications has been open since 15 April. So yeah, all applications can be done online. If you have any inquiries, you send an email to these people, they will reply to you. You can also try to call them. They really do pick up their calls, unlike other universities that I do not want to mention. They do not pick up their calls. Yeah. So if you're not sure what exactly to study, you can click at the selection information or field of study. You can just click there. It will take you to this process where you have to read more about the admission requirements, especially for per education or per faculty, where you can read the check the prospectus online, what you want to study. For example, you can be given a degree, the field that you'll be studying at this degree, then also the requirements that will be needed, the APS, at which campus you'll be studying at this university, for this program. Also, I think also career opportunities if you study this program. So this is how you check it. You can also check law and check the programs under law. You also the requirements, the field, the APS score before you can do the application. So this is how you check the requirements. Obviously, to apply, you need your ID copy, your latest school result, your academic record, your certificate if you're a postgraduate. You just need all of this document to apply at this university. So how to apply this university? Come point where it says study at. As you can see, this drop down list will come up, then click where it says apply here. Then after that, you come where it says you scroll down, come where it says undergraduate or honors or postgraduate or distant, depends what you want to apply for. Let's click where it says undergraduate, then you click this drop down arrow. Then you can come and click where it says apply online. Then if you have already have a student number, you'll click here. If you are a new applicant, you'll just click here. Then you click create a university student number. Then you enter this information, your surname and everything. Here you create your PIN here, then they will give you a student number to continue the process. But if you are reapplying, you'll just click where it says already have a student number. You just click here. Then you come here, you enter student number, you enter your PIN. If you have forgotten a PIN, you'll click here, or create new student number, you click here, or create PIN, you click here. Then you click log in. Then after that, it will verify your information, as you can see on top here. If you just made an application for this year, you can see it will take you to the last step where you have ended. So you can just click submit, or you can just click modify application. So if it is your first time, click modify application. Then after that, you click 2022. You make sure, when did you complete your matric? Are you applying for undergraduate conduct degree? What are you applying for? Highest academic level that you have completed. You make sure that you indicate, then you click next. After that, you come to your grade 12 result. You indicate whether you did an, a South African Educational Department or other system, just like Cambridge School of Tomorrow or whatsoever. Grade that you have completed, if it is grade 11, you will indicate. Then the year that you are going to complete, if you are still going to complete in grade 12, 2021, you indicate your 2021. Education, education department, you select with your province where you are staying at. Then you select the name of your school. You can make an amendment. If you have done that, if you know your examination number, you can edit it is not compulsory whatsoever. Then how did you pass your matric? If you have passed matric, you will indicate whether with a bachelor degree, diploma or higher certificate. Did you pass your matric? You can indicate. If you did not pass your matric, you will indicate. So to add your subject here, you just click add here. Then you come and select all of the subject that you did here. You select. Then at the end, when you scroll down, you just click next here. So once you are done, after entering the subject, it will take you to a step where you have to enter the percentage. Do not worry about this one. The system will just detect and write the levels for you. Yours is to write the percentages here. Then if you are satisfied with that, you just click next. Then we come to the option where you have to select your study choices. You first select the campus, then you enter the program here. Before you to attempt the application, make sure that you have at least checked the undergraduate prospectus online, or you have downloaded it. So already when you click this one, it will tell you that it will be full term and it will be conduct. And what are you applying for? So to add a second choice, you can just click, let's say, file. Then after that, you come to where it says the drop down error. This, oh, I'm here. Then you check what is under val. You scroll down and check what is under val. If you like to go to the val, let's say we want something under, let's say, computer science with statistics. You click that one. So as you can see, this one, it will be full-time conduct, and this the curriculum that we'll be doing. If you are satisfied with that, you can click next. Then after that, you confirm your biographical information. If it is correct, make sure that your names, you are from South Africa, initials, date of birth at this format, your title, name, everything. You make sure the nickname, if you want to make sure that it is correct, your status, just make sure that everything it is correct. Your disability, if you have any disability, you can indicate. If you have any disability, you can specify. Then if you are satisfied with that, you click next. Then you come to this part where you have to first, when you come here, you'll find it at like this. So make sure when you come to this POPI 8 protection of personal information, just click yes. You grant them a permission to disclose your personal information, but within the university, not outside the university. Then after that, for preferred conduct, please, you can choose whether you want email, mail, fax. I always prefer email address. Then you come and enter your email address here. You verify your email address. Then you come and enter your cell phone number. You first enter the code here. Then you come and enter your number, starting with the second number after the zero. Then you come to your residence. Make sure that you select your country, then you select your postal address, your street address, because this is the first thing, or residential address. You make sure that you have your street number, you have your street name, You can enter this one. It is not commercial. You can copy this one because we'll need it. Then you come to this one where you have to choose whether the town or postal code. You just click search here. Then after that, you can search using the postal code or you can search using the town, anything that works better for you. Then after that, you click search. As you can see, your town will come here. Then you click here to select your town, and your town will come here, and also with the postal code. If your postal address, it is different from your street address, you can click new address here. Then an option for you to enter new address, it will come up here. As you can see, this one, it just copied mine, but it does not matter. So you can enter yours a different one if you want to. Same as for the account, you can change here. If it is different, you can either add new or copy from the above addresses. Who will be paying account to whom? Who will be paying for your account? You can click yourself or other or family, but you can leave it at yourself. Then they will enter your details here. Then after that, you click next. This is just a warning. Then after that, click next. Then we come to this part where we have to enter our post school information. What are you currently doing this year? You will indicate if you are still if you are working. You will indicate if you are still a school student. If you are not working, your activity that you are doing, you indicate how many registration on an institution. Is it your first time registering at this university, or you are registering for the second time, or what? You can leave it at first time. Did you sit for an examination at the university? You can click yes if you want to. Then after that, you click next. Then you can jump all of these relationship things, but it is important to edit just in case of emergencies, but it is not important. You can jump it. Same all of this, it is not important. You can jump this. Then you come to this addresses. If you want to more about residential life, you can click to this page and check what exactly is happening with the residence life, and search per residence what is happening there. For example, this is the campus, Mafikeni, Mahikeni. You can check these are the residences under it. If you have chosen a purchase from this for men and this for ladies, for women, all of this stuff, you can check it before you do the application. So then you choose the first choice here. You can choose here, and then you can choose your second choice. You can choose your third choice. Because since you have indicated, if you have applied a different course on a different campus, also this option will pop up here. You can also choose your first choice, your second choice, and everything. Then you click next if you are satisfied with your information. Then do you have your documents here? This is where you need to upload your documents. Just click here to show document upload history. You can view your document here if you see that you have uploaded a document, but the problem is that they will save it, then you can be able to view it. But to upload your document, you just click here to upload the document. Then you upload, choose file, then you click the document that you want to upload, then you click open. Then after that, you click upload, then your document will be uploaded. It will come here, as you can see, the name of the document that you have uploaded, it has been uploaded. So you can continue to upload all of the document that you want to upload. Then after that, you click next. So it will take you to this page. Now, as you can see, this is the summary of this page, the first page that we saw if you were reapplying. Then you can modify your application, or you can click submit application. So just like that, your application has been submitted, was successfully sent to this university for further processing. So now you can just click on to go back and check. You can still modify your application if you want to. As you can see, your status is still waiting for approval. So ladies and gentlemen, this is how you apply at the North University of Technology. So is there where you are struggling? Usually some people, they do struggle at the process where you have to select study choices. Please make sure that, guys, when you reach there, just go to your browser. Then on your browser, click this more button, this one. Then go to your settings. So once you are on the settings, you come to scroll down and come where it says clear browser data history. You just click this one. Make sure that here it is all. Then you just click clear browser. Then after that, you try the process again. So if you know anyone who is struggling with the process, or you are struggling with the process, please do not hesitate to contact me. My contact details will be found on the description of this video below.